A miracle in its most general sense is simply an unexpected or unusual event, such as finding a lost item that was of value, or possibly someone's behavior changing unexpectedly. In its more restricted sense, a miracle would apply to those events that seem to go against the law of nature, such as someone emerging from an accident unscathed when everyone else dies, or someone recovering from end-stage cancer unexpectedly. Religious miracles add a different dimension, and that is that God has directly intervened in earthly affairs to bring something about. So, for example, a religious miracle would be that God brought it about that someone were healed, or that possibly someone's behavior was changed, or that something happened that we wouldn't have expected without God's involvement in that way. I cover three key questions. Is the idea of a miracle coherent, the idea of God intervening in earthly affairs? If it is coherent, can we prove that miracles happened? Would it be justified to believe that a miracle has occurred? And then thirdly, the whole idea of whether or not, given that miracles occur, why would we see so much evil in the world today? I talk about those three questions, I give philosophical perspectives on those three questions, and then I come back and give my own perspective. With respect to the first question of whether it's coherent, since most people would agree that you can't disprove God's existence, most philosophers say that it is coherent to think that God could act in a miraculous way. There's a lot of debate, though, on whether or not it would be justified to believe that God has ever done so. Some people claim that there are events such that if they were to occur, everyone would have to agree that God existed. Others claim that there's no way you could justify a belief that a miracle has occurred. I'm somewhere in between. I argue that no one would have to believe that miracles have occurred. It's justified to believe they haven't occurred. On the other hand, there's no non-question-making argument that shows that it couldn't have happened, so people are justified in believing that miracles have occurred. There is, though, a tension. If you believe that miracles occur frequently, then you have to explain why God doesn't intervene more frequently to take away all the evils in the world. On the other hand, if you say God doesn't intervene to take away evil because God wants to acknowledge our freedom, then you wouldn't expect miracles to happen as frequently. I've been writing and thinking about this for the last 40 years, and one thing I've learned is that I can be wrong, and I believe that sincere, knowledgeable people can differ on this issue. So I hope that people who read this book will contact me and share with me their perspectives, as I would like to keep doing more work in this area.